you have come before the accident, sinful sorrow. O Mother of the Word and Crown, despise not thy petition, in thy mercy, hear and hear its question.
Approach thou with some pace, and peace be. I am the salvation of the people, says the Lord. Should they cry to me in distress, I will hear them, and I will be their Lord forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Seated at the right hand of the Father, to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, they make kings in Israel, but not by my authority. They establish princes, but without my approval. With their silver and gold they made idols for themselves, to their own destruction. Cast away your cap, O Samaria, my wrath is kindled against them. How long will they be unable to retain innocence in Israel? The work of an artesian, no God at all. Destined for the flames, such is the cap of Samaria. When they sow the wind, they shall reap the whirlwind. The stalk of grain that forms no ear can yield no flower. Even if it could, strangers would swallow. When Ephraim made many altars to expiate sin, his altars became occasions of sin. Though I write for him my many ordinances, they are considered as a stranger. Though they offer sacrifice, emulate flesh, and eat it, the Lord is not pleased with them. He shall still remember their guilt and punish their sins. They shall return to Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, the handiwork of men.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
They have mouths, but speak not. They have eyes, but see not. They have ears, but hear not. They have noses, but smell not.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
They have hands, but feel not. They have feet, but walk not. Their makers shall be like them, everyone that trusts in them.
Out, the mute man spoke. The crowds were amazed and
Nothing like this has ever been seen in Israel. But the Pharisees said, he drives out demons by the prince of demons. Jesus went around to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I want to sort of open up as a sort of follow-up to yesterday's homily. I know some of you were, some of you out there were there for Mass last night, others not. That's okay. It's not quite an apology, but it was one of those days where afterwards I felt like I was all over the place. Like, that was one of the most ADD homilies I've ever given. Like, if I could summarize the whole homily, I would say the summary was, you guys, I'm really excited. Like, St. Maria Goretti is just awesome. Of course, because yesterday we did celebrate the Feast of St. Maria Goretti. And besides sort of poking fun at myself, hopefully having a laugh about it, that's my other motivation for mentioning it, is that I just kind of want to remind us that yesterday was the feast of a great saint who reminds us all to be praying for our young people. And part of what I was thinking too is, part of why I was so excited is I was just seeing from all angles how everything was tied together, from the saint to the readings to other things we've been talking about in the liturgy recently. And year to year, Maria Goretti, and this is what I was thinking about afterwards, like that little girl, that 12-year-old little girl is just a powerhouse of grace. Like every year, in one way or another, her feast day doesn't just come and go without being noticed. Every year, she wants to stop us and get our attention and remind us to be praying for our young people, and to be praying for that unwavering commitment to Christ. And so to follow up that with a gospel, hopefully a homily that is just so utterly straightforward, there's something nice about that, because I think there is something completely very straightforward about where we are as we now jump back in. And yesterday we had the weekday readings. If you remember, that was part of what I was excited about. The weekday readings were perfect for the saint. It's one of those days. But today we can focus a little bit more about where are our weekday readings putting us right now. Because yesterday we started a new prophet, a new book of the prophets in our first reading, which was Hosea. And you might remember last week, we were looking at the prophet Amos. Now it's interesting because Amos, it has a strong emphasis of justice and calling out injustice, calling out Israel for their injustice and calling them to repent. And Hosea has a strong emphasis on love. Hosea has a strong emphasis on the fact that God has called Israel to be his beloved, the one who is espoused to him, his bride, and her heart has warmed, and he intends to call her back. And so the continuity between these two prophets, and there is a lot of continuity between them, is so striking to point to the fact that when we see this evidence of injustice in our world, in our culture, even in our church, perhaps in our homes, things of which we individually and as a people need to repent, we remember where it all starts and in a sense where it all ends. It starts and ends with love. The God who is love loves us perfectly and calls us to love. When our hearts have wandered, and they do so very easily, as weak and fickle people as we are, he calls us back. He calls us to turn our hearts back to him. Again, the simplicity of that college that we prayed at the beginning of Mass, The commandments of God's law are rooted in love, love of Him and love of our neighbor. And so the Lord is calling us to love. And that is also what is so simple and striking about this gospel. At the very end, especially when he says, the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few, so ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Now, when we read the recording of Luke passing on these words of our Lord, I love to point out that, you know, we use these words to talk about praying for more priests, and we should pray for more priests. Absolutely, please do. I'd be foolish because it'd be like saying, I never want to retire for you. Me to not tell you to pray for priests. Pray for priests, please do. Right? But it's always, when it comes up in Luke, I always point out that we talk about this verse in light of praying for priests, but in Luke, he sends it as he's sending out the 72. In other words, not the ordained, the lay disciples, the lay faithful. Right? And so, here it's a little different, because here, now, you might have noticed that this is one of those periods in the church here in which we're reading the same gospel during weekdays and on weekends. So we're in different parts of Matthew, and the exciting thing is we're nearing a collision point where our weekday readings are about to catch up to our Sunday readings, right? I've been talking the past few weeks about how we've been in this section of Matthew, right, where Jesus has just sent out his 12 apostles, right? He names them and then immediately sends them out, right? And he sends them out, what, as sheep amidst wolves. Those are going to be our readings at the end of this week. So we're coming close to that point where to understand what's happening here is that one thing that's sort of in the background is that Jesus is preparing, and they probably don't know it yet, but he's about to name 12 of them as his apostles, empower them by his grace, and send them out on mission. And what we see when we look at a reading like this to realize that he is going to send them out, and he's going to send them out as sheep amidst wolves. He's going to send them out knowing that they're going to encounter resistance. They're going to encounter rejection. They're going to encounter all manner of difficulties. Is that it becomes clear that when they encounter that, they will be rejected because the people rejected Christ first. You see that? Before he sends them out and they begin to experience rejection, Christ himself is rejected. So in those difficulties, in that rejection, in that pain, they are not alone. Christ is with them. And so we see that at work, but we also see that, as I said, he hasn't even called his 12. He hasn't even named his priests. And already, he's saying, the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. Pray to the master of the harvest to send more laborers into the harvest. Now, it's not as if he's saying, you guys, I need to pick my priests, and I'm looking, and it's slim picking. I need more people to pick from, right? That's not what he's saying, right? It points to the simplicity of what he's asking us to pray for. Is, I'm going to name some priests soon. That's important, but just pray for more people to follow me. Pray for more people to follow me. If we understood the simplicity of that plea of our Lord, because to follow him is to be invested in the care of the garden, right? The laborers sent out in the harvest, right? To follow him is to care about the spread of the gospel, is to care about the salvation of our neighbor, is to care about whether this person knows who Jesus is and really knows him, not knows him as some head of some religion, but is the God of truth and love who knows them by name and calls them to be his own. That's what our Lord is asking us to pray for. And indeed, in a very humble way, rooted in prayerful surrender, to work for. That there be more laborers in the harvest, that there be more who simply follow. The question of what vocation you'll be called to, it's not that it's not important, it's that's not the question we're looking at right now. We're looking at, will they follow? Will I choose to follow them? When my heart is wandering, and I recognize that because my heart has wandered from the Lord, that all manner of injustice has crept into my life, will I let him call me back to himself and remind me that I am his? That is the simple plea that is on our Lord's heart today, is that we would choose to follow him and love him. May we each seek to satisfy that desire of the Lord's heart by making that choice ourselves to follow him and to love him. So we place all of our prayers in the hands of our loving Father as we pray for the whole church, Francis, our Pope, and our Bishop, for all the clergy and all the faithful. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our world, for an increase in peace, justice, and respect for all human life. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our community, especially any among us who may be sick, suffering, hurting in any way, that they may know the consolation of Jesus Christ crucified and the hope of his resurrection. We pray to the Lord. For the peaceful repose of Joanne Smith, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all of those near and dear to our own hearts, we pray to the Lord. For the freedom and purification of the Church. Saint Michael, we are praying to the Lord. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God be with you in your prayer. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into the hell of Satan and all evil spirits, who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. With loving confidence, Heavenly Father, we entrust all of our prayers to you, trusting in your holy will, for you are good, and your love endures forever. We ask all of these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, the fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the wine and offering, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, as the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and saved from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word. Please sanitize your hands where your mask as you come forward. Then simply pull your mask up or down to receive our Lord and replace it. Communion and Father. You have laid down your precepts to be carefully held. May my ways be firm and you keep them at hand.
Thank you. are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Whether or not I can now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you are already there, I embrace you and unite myself fully to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those who renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou.